In this video, we're going to set up a SharePoint calendar from scratch. Right now, I'm in my brand new demo team, and the first thing I need to do is click onto Files, and then Open in SharePoint. If you don't see Open in SharePoint, look for three dots, and you should see that within that button. Once SharePoint has opened, we need to click onto Site Contents. Because the site is brand new, I want to convert it into the Australian time zone. To do that, click on Site Settings up the top right. We now need to find Regional Settings and then update the locale from English United States to English Australia. Scroll down and click on OK. From there, click onto Site Contents again. And what we're looking for now is the new button and then app. We now get a long list of SharePoint apps that we can add. And the one that we're looking for is calendar. I usually just type in CAL and press enter to filter those results. And we're looking for the calendar in a teal box. Click onto that. From there, we need to give our calendar a name. And this is going to be my partnership calendar. Click on Create to continue. Now within this calendar, I want to also add a primary calendar and also an early years calendar. So I'll repeat that for those two calendars. New app cal search. When I click onto my calendars, they will default into a month view. Now for these calendars, I actually want it in a week view. So I need to go through each new calendar and change it to a week view. The way that I do that is to right click my new calendar, click onto settings, scroll down to where it says views and then calendar, and then from there, I want to change my default scope from a month to a week. Scroll down and click on OK. If you'd like to leave your calendar in a month view, don't worry about changing these settings. And I'll repeat for the remaining calendars. So back onto Site Contents, right click, settings, scroll down to Views, Calendar, and update my default scope. Now, when I click onto one of my calendars, it shows in a week view. This partnership calendar is my parent calendar, and to add additional calendars to it, I need to click onto the calendar tab up the top and then go to calendars overlay. Once there, if I bring my mouse down, I've got the new calendar link, and this is what I can use to add those new calendars to this view. Calendar name should be a name to describe one of your new calendars. I'm just going to pick the ones that I've already created. So primary. And I can come down and pick a color. So just keep in mind, the second in the list is reserved for the active calendar, and that will make sense in a moment. So go ahead and choose any other color but the second one. I'm happy to keep it as the first. Under web URL, we need to click on resolve. And then under list, we need to select the correct calendar. So I'm adding primary. That means I need to use this drop down and select primary. And then click on to OK. And then I'll repeat for early childhood. Once I'm done, I can click on OK again to return to the calendar view. And I'll see I've got my partnership calendar in that lighter teal, primary in a darker blue and early childhood in green. To add an event to the primary calendar, I do need to select primary. And when I do that, you can see it changes to that lighter teal color and I can see that I'm in the primary calendar. So I can go ahead and I can add an event. Click save. And now to return to that calendar, I actually need to go back under site contents or recent and click onto partnership calendar. And there I can see that primary meeting. It's completely up to you, but I personally like to add a shortcut back to my partnership calendar from the individual ones. So to do that, I go into primary, go into calendar up the top, calendars overlay, new calendar, and we can type something like back to partnership calendar. And for our color, I'm just going to go with the last one, which is brown. Resolve and change that to the partnership calendar and click on OK. And OK again. Now you can see I'm in the primary calendar and I can click back onto back to partnership calendar. Click onto that. And I'm back in that calendar. Now, if I repeat in early childhood, we can see that I don't have that back button. So again, calendar, calendars overlay, and repeat. So to add an event into early childhood, I need to click onto early childhood. And now I can go ahead and add an event. And click on save. When I click on my back button, I can see that I now have two different colors in that main partnership calendar. To finish this off, I can add this as a shortcut into my team. To do that, I can select the web address, so the entire thing, right click and go to copy. I then go into Teams. I choose the channel that I'd like to add this calendar to, click on the plus button to add a tab, select website, give my tab a name, it can be as simple as calendar, paste in the URL, untick the button that says post to this channel about the tab, and click on save. If prompted, select the account that you'd like to view the calendar with. This should be your school's one. And that calendar will now display directly from within your team.